Okay, good afternoon, class.
Good afternoon, Miss.
Good afternoon, Miss.
Good afternoon, Ma'am.
Okay, welcome again to our Community Engagement, Solidarity, and Citizenship class. Today, we will learn about the different core values of community action initiatives: human rights, social equity, gender equality, and participatory development. Since these four are broad topics, we will be focusing more on human rights for today. To kickstart today's discussion, let's first have a game. We are going to play Four Picks, One Word. For this game, you have to guess what the word is by looking at four pictures with one common word. The points and scores that you receive depends on how fast you answer a stage and the numbers of letters of the correct word. Okay, we have the first four pictures. You can just raise your hand if you want to answer. Miss Cherise, you can answer.
Infant, ma'am.
That's not the correct answer, but nice try. Who wants to try again? Mary Hybeil.
Citizens, ma'am.
Citizens, okay, that's correct. Next four pictures, who wants to try?
Solidarity, ma'am.
Solidarity, no, incorrect. Who wants to try again? Any other hand who wants to answer? Faith?
Equality, ma'am.
Equality, no. Apple?
I think it's fairness, ma'am.
Fairness, okay, that's correct. Next three, Mary Hybeil.
Justice, ma'am.
Justice, no. Who wants to answer again? Miss Cherise.
Liberty, ma'am.
Liberty, okay, that's correct. Let's move on to the fourth four picks. Who wants to answer? Miss Faith?
Education, ma'am.
Education? No, it's close to education. Miss Jile?
Schooling, ma'am.
Okay, that's right. The last given four picks we have. Who wants to try? Miss Hybeil.
BioLife, ma'am.
No, it's not BioLife, but it's close to it again. Who wants to try? Miss Faith?
It's Pro-Life, ma'am.
Okay, that's correct. Thank you for your answers, and now we will proceed to another game. It is word search. For the mechanics of this game, students are tasked to locate the given words in the grid. The terms presented are related to what you would think about it if you heard the word human rights. Either word has the option of being organized horizontally, vertically, diagonally, or backward. You can just raise your hand if you want to answer again, okay? Okay, first we have, who wants to answer? Miss Hybeil.
Property, ma'am.
Property? Okay, Miss Jile.
Liberty, ma'am.
Liberty. Miss Crystal.
Justice, ma'am.
Justice, okay. Miss Cherise.
Declaration, ma'am.
Declaration. Miss Faith.
Privacy, ma'am.
Okay. Next, who wants to try?
Me, ma'am, I'm going to answer.
Okay.
Belief.
Belief. That's correct. Next.
I think that's all, ma'am. No more words.
Okay. That was an entertaining game. Thank you all for your cooperation. As you can infer from the game that we played, we will discuss human rights and their role as a core value of community action initiatives. Human rights are the basic rights and freedoms that belong to every person in the world from birth until death. They apply regardless of where you are from, what you believe, or how you choose to live your life. They can never be taken away, although they can sometimes be restricted. These basic rights are based on shared values like dignity, fairness, equality, respect, and independence. These values are defined and protected by the law. How does human rights help you? Human rights are relevant to all of us, not just those who face oppression or mistreatment. So human rights are for everybody and without exception. They protect you in many areas of your day-to-day life, including your right to have and express your own opinion, your right to an education, your right to a private and family life, your right not to be mistreated or wrongly punished by the state. Okay, during our last meeting, I grouped you into two groups, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I already informed the leaders of each group that we will have a debate about the topic pro-life versus pro-choice, a debate about abortion. I chose this topic because it is relevant and also one of the fundamental human rights is the right to life. Your group, Ms. Sereno, will be affirmative. Is that correct?
Yes, miss.
Okay, while your group, Ms. Orbita, will be on the negative side.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I hope you have prepared your arguments over the weekend. The mechanics of this short informal debate are the first speaker for the affirmative side begins, then the first speaker for the negative side responds. In this way, the speakers for both sides speak in turn. After the first speaker for the affirmative side has spoken, a speaker from the negative team has the last word. The order of speakers must not be changed. Each speaker has a maximum time of 1 minute and 30 seconds. The chairperson checks the time carefully. She gives a sign when the speaker has 10 seconds to go. And after speaking time is over, the speaker may finish his or her sentence and must then stop. their time may not be transferred to another speaker. To start the debate, I would like to give the floor to the affirmative team.
Good afternoon, Ms. Marjorie, and to you all, my classmates. The topic of our debate is pro-life versus pro-choice. We, the affirmative team, believe that every individual has the right to decide freely and responsibly without discrimination, coercion, and violence. The number, gap, and timing of their children and the right to attain the highest standard of sexual and reproductive health, access to legal, safe, and comprehensive abortion care, including post-abortion care, is essential for the attainment of the highest possible level of sexual and reproductive health. 3 out of 10 of all pregnancies end in abortion. Nearly half of all abortions are unsafe, and almost all of these unsafe abortions take place in the developing countries. When women with unwanted pregnancies do not have access to safe abortion, they have resort to unsafe abortion. And an abortion is unsafe when it is carried out either by a personnel lacking the necessary skills or in an environment that does not conform to minimum medical standards, or both. Characteristics of an unsafe abortion touch upon inappropriate circumstances before, during, or after an abortion. So, unsafe abortion can lead to immediate health risk, or including death, as well as long-term complications affecting women's physical and mental health and well-being throughout her life course. That would be all.
Good afternoon, Ms. Marjorie, ladies and gentlemen. The topic of our debate is pro-life versus pro-choice. We, the negative team, believe that every life has the right to live. The biological and medical advances of today posits and acknowledges that the human organism that emerges from fertilization is a member of the human species, a living person. As the fetus continues to evolve along her developmental trajectory, she needs an environment and sustenance that will help her grow, not kill her. Moreover, the fetus is also entitled to rights of equality and justice, which entails that all individual beings deserve equal protection under the law. Excluding the fetus from such rights, an entire segment of the human family for any reason, such as dependence and biological immaturity, is injustice, discrimination in the highest order. That will be all, ma'am. Thank you.
So this is Jai Rose Ochapatekson, and I am the speaker for the affirmative side, or the pro-choice. So I grew up in a Christian home, as my mother is a Christian, and one of the things that she instilled in me, which I used to hear it so much, was free will. It was ingrained in me that you have the ability to make choices. You have the ability to decide what you want to do. You are responsible for your decisions, as God has given you that responsibility, that option to make decisions. I had firsthand experience of seeing women being disproportionately impacted by the fact that they had no choices about an intended pregnancy, even if it would damage their health or cause great hardship in their family. And I remember some of them being maimed in back alley abortions, which some of them died. Unfortunately, there was no legal choice before Roe versus Wade. But in this day and time, we have a clearer understanding that men and women are moral agents and equipped to make decisions about even the most difficult and complex matters. We must ensure a woman can determine when and whether to have children according to her own conscience and religious beliefs, and without governmental interference or coercion. We must also ensure that women have the resources to have a healthy, safe pregnancy if that is their decision, and that women and families have the resources to raise a child with security. The right to choose has changed and expanded over the years since Roe versus Wade. We now speak for reproductive justice, and that includes comprehensive sex education, family planning and contraception, adequate medical care, and a safe environment. The ability to continue a pregnancy and the resources to make the choice possible. That is my moral framework. And I now rest my case.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Faith Ninia Manarinia, part of the negative team. Like toddler or adolescent, the terms embryo and fetus do not refer to non-humans, but to humans at particular stages of development. Semantics affect perceptions, but they do not change realities. A baby is a baby no matter what we call her. From the moment of conception, the unborn is not simple, but very complex. Prior to the earliest abortions, the unborn already has every part she will ever have. Every abortion stops a beating heart and terminates measurable brain waves. Even in the earliest surgical abortions, the unborn child is clearly human in appearance. Even before the unborn is obviously human in appearance, she is what she is, a human being. No matter how much better it sounds, terminating a pregnancy is still terminating a life. Abortion is not safer than full-term pregnancy and childbirth, though the chances of a woman's safe abortion are now greater. The number of suffering women is also greater because of the huge increase in abortions. Even if abortion were safer for the mother than childbirth, it would still remain fatal for the innocent child. Abortion can produce many serious medical problems. Abortion significantly raises the rate of breast cancer. The statistics on abortion complications and risk are often understated due to the inadequate means of gathering data. The true risk of abortion are rarely explained to women by those who perform abortions. What is most unfair to unwanted children is to kill them. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Ms. Marjorie. Good afternoon, everyone, ladies and gentlemen. I am Trice K. Antihano, and I am the third speaker for the affirmative team. So this argument reminds us that even in the abortion debate, we should regard the woman as a person and not just as a container for the fetus. We should therefore give focus to the needs as well as to those of the unborn. Pro-choice women's rights activists do not take a casual or callous attitude to the fetus. The opposite is usually true. And most of them acknowledge that choosing an abortion is usually a case of choosing the least bad of several bad courses of action. Women need the right to abortion to have full rights over their own bodies, including the right to decide whether or not to carry a fetus to birth. Without this right, they do not have the same moral status as men. Furthermore, many people regard the right to control one's own body as a key moral right, and one that women could only achieve if they were entitled to abort an unwanted fetus. If women are not allowed to abort an unwanted fetus, then they are deprived of this right. First, a woman has the right to decide what she can and can't do with her body, and second, the fetus exists inside a woman's body, and lastly, a woman has the right to decide whether the fetus remains in her body. Therefore, a pregnant woman has the right to abort the fetus. That's all. Thank you.
Good afternoon. This is Ace, the last speaker for the negative team. So the key terms in this argument are responsibility, choices, and right to life. Depriving a fetus of its life is never gonna be okay, no matter the excuses and the circumstances the woman have been facing. She is not ready, it's her body and she has the right to it, it's her choice. Then, women should have been extra careful and uses all means to avoid unwanted pregnancy. According to data, contraceptives are more than 99% effective if used correctly, like the contraceptive implant. Abortion causes various unavoidable side effects in women. It can be physical, emotional, and mental. Responsibility and consequences always comes together. Each one of us is accountable for our own actions, learning between what is right and wrong. Engaging in sexual activities should not have been taken carelessly, as a child could be created in that complex unity. A man and woman should be responsible enough to accept the repercussions of their actions. To summarize this argument, I believe that humans have the right to life. As a result, fetuses have the right to life. Of course, women have the right to govern their own bodies, but the right to life takes precedence over the right to manage one's own body. As a result, and in any aspect, abortion is wrong. That concludes our argument. Thank you.
Okay, that was a very nice debate, no? So for the criteria, last time we already discussed about it, pero ako lang balikon. Organization of ideas, 30 points. Cross-examination, 20 points. Quality of arguments, 30 points. And oral delivery, 20 points. And for the total, we have 100. So for your debate, that was very informative. You guys all have a very wide perspective about pro-life versus pro-choice. I would like to commend both groups for presenting arguments that are well explained and analyzed. Also, all of the members of the group presented their ideas logically and sequentially. Please tap yourself on the back or your shoulders for a job well done. Since we are running out of time, I would just give you an assignment. Please draw what comes into your mind when you hear the word human rights. Please prepare a short explanation of your drawing because we will present it for tomorrow. I think that is it for today. Thank you for attending the class. See you tomorrow. God bless and stay safe.
Goodbye, ma'am. Thank you.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye. Good afternoon, class.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome again to our Community Engagement, Solidarity, and Citizenship class. Today, we will continue discussing the different core values of community action initiatives, human rights, social equity, gender equality, and participatory development. Yesterday, I gave you an assignment, right?
Yes, ma'am.
What was the assignment again, Ms. Therese?
You asked us, ma'am, to draw what comes into our minds when we hear the words human rights, and you also told us to prepare a short explanation for our drawings. We will present them today.
Okay, very good. So, who wants to volunteer? Who wants to show first their drawing and explain? Should I call Miss Rosalinda?
We are tasked to make whatever we can think about on the subject human rights. So, basically, this is what I draw. can see here, naay kamot then nakalingkaw siya sa pagkapiso, and there are words like liberate and empower. So this picture depicts human rights. So as what we've learned, human rights are the basic rights and freedoms that belong to every person in the world. So this right is important because human rights connect us to each other through a shared set of rights and responsibilities. A person's ability to enjoy their human rights depends on other people respecting those rights. This means that human rights involve responsibility and duties towards other people with the community. So individuals have a responsibility to ensure that they exercise their rights with consideration for the rights of others. For instance, when someone uses their right to freedom of speech, they should do so without interfering with someone else's rights to privacy.
Okay, that was a very nice drawing, no? Related kayo siya sa atong topic. Our next volunteer is Ms. Kija.
Human rights are the standard of human behavior following morals and norms in society. Human rights are a necessary entity for every person regardless of gender, race, or sexuality. While each country has its own set of human rights, the fundamental core of human rights is to ensure that a person lives free and dignified with access to basic necessities and to be treated with respect by others. Human rights change along with society, so it evolved over time to accommodate changes in norms and moral ideas. However, the essence remains the same. Human rights exist so that people are free to live and exist as they fit within a set of morals and norms.
Okay, that was again a very amazing drawing and explanation. Last to present is Mr. Jack.
Good evening. As you can see from this picture, you can see a man breaking away from his chains, symbolizing freedom. On a similar note, human rights offers the same thing, freedom. Whether it's freedom to say what we want, to eat what we want, to go where we want, or to pick a religion and dedicate the rest of our lives to it. It's the same. Human rights offers us freedom. Freedom to choose. And that, my friends, is what makes it a privilege that should not be squandered or even abused.
Okay, that was a very amazing drawing and explanation, Mr. Jack. So I just received a message from your advisor. I was informed that you have an important seminar that you all need to attend. We have to cut our class short. I will continue the presentation of the drawings tomorrow. I hope you listen to the seminar because I will ask questions about your seminar for our discussion tomorrow. Okay? Thank you for attending the class. See you tomorrow and goodbye. Stay safe and God bless you all.
Thank you, man.
Thank you, goodbye. Thanks, Denise.